My Designer from the What Was Good Design exhibition of 1944 to 1956 is George Nelson. Nelson was born in 1908 in Hartford, Connecticut. Nelson studied architecture at Yale University during 1928 to 1931 after seeking refuge there during a rainstorm. There he stumbled upon other students' work on display and was immediately inspired by their designs. After university and during the Great Depression, Nelson entered a competition that won him a two-year scholarship to attend the American Academy in Rome from 1932 to 1934. Whilst attending this academy, Nelson conducted interviews for a series of 12 portraits on other modern European architects. According to George Nelson Foundation, it including leading influences like Le Corbusier, Miles van der Rohe, Walter Gropius, Geoponti, and more. This piece was subsequently published in the magazine Pencil Point. Nelson continued to work with magazines such as Architecture Forum and Fortune during 1935, where he became an associate editor. In 1938, he wrote his first book on architect, Albert Kahn. Nelson later substituted his career as a magazine editor to begin teaching architecture at Columbia University during World War II. During this time, he continued to write and design various projects. In 1942, Nelson went on to design the concept Grass on Main Street, that is commonly known today as Pedestrian Mall. The following year, Nelson expands into furniture design with the creation of the Storage Wall. The Storage Wall was published in the Life magazine later that year. Life magazine described the Storage Wall as a carefully designed system to create a minimalist look while storing everything from bikes to kites. The design was so successful, it is still widely used today in offices around the world. Continuing on from the success of the Storage Wall, Nelson went on to design his first collection of furniture in 1945 for Herman Miller. This solidifies his transition from architect to furniture designer. In his new role, he would proceed to make hundreds of pieces for Herman Miller that today still remain an industry standard. After recruiting heavily influential designers such as Charles and Ray Eames, Nelson continues recruiting other promising designers to produce work for Herman Miller. Nelson used photography to teach students and the public the importance of design through the captured image. He was known to always carry a camera for this purpose. He did so via multiple mediums such as a film projection, audio recordings, and much more. Not only a designer, but a teacher and a writer, Nelson was and continues to be an influence to many. Nelson's designs stay current and relevant today despite his death in 1986. Nelson's mobile table was chosen to be a part of the What Was Good Design exhibition. The exhibition, featured at the Museum of Modern Art, focused on the Dieter Rams 10 Principles of Good Design. Nelson's mobile table resonated with many of these principles. Nelson's mobile table is innovative due to its simple design that merges well into the modern living space. The piece is minimalistic and would suit modern homes due to its simple nature. It is unobtrusive due to its streamlined design and it blends well within its environment. The mobile table does not pull focus, but rather complements the items that are placed on top of it. The table is long-lasting. His designs remain a quality piece and are still for sale today or featured in museums. Nelson's designs were built with integrity and durability, which is a quality that resonates with Herman Miller's furniture. Nelson designed the mobile table to have as little design as possible. It is a simple, minimalist, and transparent design that complements any modernist environment. The table came in white and beige with a solid black enamel iron frame. The two colours are aesthetically pleasing in the modern home. Nelson's designs prove that a piece of furniture doesn't have to be bold in colour and form for it to be a great and creative design. Minimal designs can remain relevant and contemporary, which is a principle I need to remember when working on personal designs. It is easy as a designer to reciprocate a style or a trend that is fashionable but short-lived, rather than focusing on a creative and new design that is classic, timeless, and universal. Nelson once said that design is a response to social change. He attempts to move beyond this with the design of the mobile table, creating a piece that is timeless and universal whilst ignoring fleeting fashion. George Nelson's marshmallow sofa is a stark contrast to the mobile table in that it is bold in colour and design. As a designer, I want to create similarly timeless designs that of the mobile table. I want my designs to be environmentally friendly due to the sheer length of time that the pieces will last for. I want my pieces to be centered around principles such as durability, minimalism, and to be a product that is ethically made with integrity. Nelson's designs, whether intended or not, have become environmentally friendly due to the craftsmanship that was used during their construction. This construction has made the piece highly durable, and the minimalistic style has kept the piece relevant within the modern world. The mobile table design therefore pulled away from the mass-produced, materialistic nature of the furniture industry, where the fashion is ever-changing and highly disposable. My previous designed business cards, although unlikely to be timeless, were produced with biodegradable paper and I used vegetable inks that are better for the environment. The next generation of designers have the power to minimise waste with their creations, and it is highly important to incorporate and be influenced by the 10 principles of design when producing.